In this video, I want to show you how to install Parrot OS on a USB key and how to configure it for persistence. If you're not yet subscribed to my channel and you find my channel interesting, please take a moment to subscribe. This will greatly help the channel. To install Parrot OS on a USB key and configure persistence, you have these four requirements. First, you need the Parrot OS ISO file from parrotsec.org. Second, you need a high-speed 3.0 USB key that is 16 GB or more. I'm going to leave a link for a recommended USB key in the description. Third, you need Balena Etcher to flash the ISO file to the USB key. And I'm using here Balena Etcher because this is a recommended method on parrotsec.org. And fourth, you need a Windows 10 PC so that you can perform all these operations on this PC. So let's start with the first step, which is downloading Parrot OS from the ParrotSec site. Open your web browser, go to parrotsec.org, on the ParrotSec site, click on download, and you see here you have three editions. You have the home edition, which doesn't contain the penetration testing programs. You have the security edition, which contains the penetration testing programs, and you have the IoT edition. In our case here, you can download either the home edition or the security edition. For the purpose of this video, I'm gonna download the security edition. So click on Get Security Edition. And here you see that you have your Matte edition, which is a lightweight edition, and you have your KDE edition. I'm gonna download the KDE edition because it's richer, its desktop is richer, and it allows for more customizations. So under the KDE edition, you have GetTorrent. So this way, if you have a torrent client, you can download the KDE edition via torrent. Or if you don't have a torrent client, like in my case here, I'm gonna click on Select Server. And here simply click on Download Now. And the download begins. It's a pretty big download. It's 4.2 gigabytes, as you see. So I'm gonna cut this video and come back when the download finishes. So now the download finished, and here's the file we downloaded. So this is a Parrot KDE Security ISO file. Now we need to download Balena Etcher so to be able to flash the ISO file to a USB key. So open a new tab in your browser and then go to balena.io. And here you need to hover over More Products and then select Balena Etcher. And simply here click on Download for Windows. So here's Balena Etcher downloading. I'm gonna accelerate the video and come back when the download finishes. So now Balena Etcher has been downloaded. And as you see, it is here. We need to install it. So double click on the downloaded file, Balena Etcher Setup. And then click I agree. And you see it was installed and it ran directly. So at this stage here, you need to insert the USB key. I'm using here a Samsung Bar Plus USB key. So now I inserted the USB key. So of course, if Balena Etcher didn't start, you can start it either from the icon or from the search box here by typing Balena. So first you need to select the ISO file. So click on Flash from File, and here go to the Downloads folder or to the folder where you downloaded the ISO file of Parrot, and then select the ISO file of Parrot and click on Open. So here, as you notice, that Balena Etcher selected the wrong USB key. It selected my SD card. So click on the name here, whatever it is, just to make sure that you're selecting the correct USB key, because everything on it will be wiped. So click here and then click on Change, and deselect the USB key that was selected automatically by Etcher, and then select the USB key that you want to put the ISO file on. In my case, it is the Samsung flash drive. So I'm gonna select it and click on select, and make sure only one here is next to select. This way you make sure that you selected the correct USB drive, and everything once again on it will be wiped. So select the correct one. And then click on flash. If you have a very large USB key, which is my case here, it will give you a warning. So just click on yes, I'm sure, and the flashing will start. Click on yes here if prompted. And it shouldn't take long because USB key is very fast. I'm gonna accelerate the video and come back when the flashing finishes. And now the flashing of the USB key is finished. At this stage, you need to close Balena Etcher. If you prompted here to format, of course, click on cancel. And you need to remove the USB key. And I'm gonna switch now to an external camera and show you how to start the PC from the USB key and how to configure Parrot for persistence. So here I am inserting the USB key in the laptop that I'll be using to load Parrot OS on. And now I'm starting the laptop and I'm gonna boot from the USB key. To do this, I should press F12 because this is a Dell laptop. I'm gonna put a list of hot boot keys in the description below so that you can see which key you should press for your own laptop. So here I chose USB and then this is Parrot OS loaded. And then I chose try and install. And this is Parrot OS loading. Now it is loading in the live version without persistence. So I'm gonna show you in a bit how to configure the persistence. So just wait for it to load. So now we need to configure the persistence. To do this, we need to do three things. First, we need to create a partition, an X4 partition on the free space of the USB key. The second thing is to name this partition persistence. And the third thing is to create a file called persistence.conf in this partition. So at this stage, we need to start a program called gparted. So click on the menu and then choose system. And then under system, click on gparted. So now the purpose of gparted is to create a partition on the USB key. So I'm gonna select the USB key. On the drop-down menu, I clicked on the selection and then I selected the USB key. And as you see here, gparted sees it as a big partition. So we need to correct this. To correct this, make a note of the USB key name, which is /dev/sdb here, and open the terminal window. So in the terminal window, we need to key in the following command, sudo su, so that we work as an administrator. And then here we need to key in the command wipefs /dev/sdb because this is the name of the USB key. And here you see that we have a big ISO partition. So we need to delete a small indicator on this partition. So key in wipefs -o space, and you see here the offset 0x8001, put it here, and then minus F for force, /dev/sdb, and hit enter. And this will correct the partition schema of the USB. And let me refresh here gparted. And you see now it sees the USB key as it should see it. So we have a small partition where the operating system was installed. And here we need to create a new partition. So right click on the empty space and then select new. And here keep the size by default. By default, it will take all the size. And file system, keep it X4. And for label, it's very important to name it persistence. And then click on add. And now we need to apply the changes. So click on edit and then apply. And then click apply. So the changes are being written to the USB key now. So what we did here is that we created a partition on the USB key using the empty space and we named this partition persistence. So now everything is finished. Let me close this. And now we need to go back to the terminal window and we need to create a file. So to be able to do this, we need first to make a directory in which we can mount the USB key. So here I'm typing make dir -p space /mount/USB. So I created a folder called mount USB. And then I'm gonna mount the USB in this folder. So mount /dev/sdb3. And this is the name of the partition as you see. It is /dev/sdb3. Of course, here if you have another name for the partition, use it. /mnt/usb, And here we need to create a file called persistence.conf, and we should put /union as a first line in this text file. So to do this, this is a command, echo /union:\mnt\usb\persistence.conf, and hit enter, and now the file is created. So now the configuration of the partition is done, and let's restart PartOS. I'm gonna of course start it from the USB key once again, and this time I'm gonna choose advanced, and I'm gonna choose persistent. So this is here, I'm starting from the USB key, and here I'm choosing advanced mode. And then under advanced mode, I'm gonna choose persistence. So here's PartOS started, and this time it started in persistent mode. The first thing I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna connect to my wireless network. And this is a configuration that will persist, and you're gonna see later on when I restart the PC with PartOS. So here I'm putting the password for my Wi-Fi, and here it is connected. And let me change now the desktop background. So right click the desktop and change the background. I'm gonna choose anything here. So this is a nice picture. And this configuration will also persist. Let me create a folder now. I'm gonna name it like my test folder. And here's the folder. And I'm gonna create a file in the folder. And all these changes that I made will persist. So now I'm gonna shut down the system and restart it. And of course, each time I restart the system, I'm gonna restart it from the USB key. And by the way, you can take this USB key with you and start it on any PC, and all your persistence and configurations will be on this USB key. And you see here that the desktop background that I chose is still here. The Wi-Fi connection is here, the folder I created is here, and the file in the folder I created is also here, and everything that I wrote in it also persisted. And that was all. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. If you did, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. Thank you for watching.